Rabbi said, a man can live under a tree, he doesn't need anything. But as soon as he's married, he must get an apartment, he must have so many things. He said, so stay brahmachari, easy. And he says, I'm traveling to preach. He said, I like very much this traveling and preaching that you're doing. Because each place you never become attached and you become helps you spiritually to travel and preach. And then he also was so, he told us why we were getting his personal darshan, and that was because we were distributing his books. And he said that this meant that we were all his gems. He said, of all of his disciples, we were his gems. So we really thought, wow. I've only been here 3 months and I'm already a gem. Really, I just hit that jackpot. You know, so we were probably was always very, very appreciative of the devotees. I cannot stress how much Prabhupada appreciates the service that everyone performs in the temple. Everyone. And Vrindavan, Prabhupada, I was in Vrindavan with Srila Prabhupada the last couple of weeks, and Prabhupada would hear the arti. And when he'd hear the arti, he'd say, and he'd hear the conch shell blow, he'd go, this is the perfection of human life. He said, to be a pujari is the perfection of human life. He said, this is the highest form of evolution that the soul takes in the material world, is to be a pujari. He said, why? Because he is performing his eternal position at this moment in a material form. He said, so this is the highest form to be a pujari. Any other services under this, pujari is the most elevated and sacred place. And I never heard anyone tell me that. I always thought book distribution was the highest. But Prabhupada said, no, pujari is the highest position that a soul can attain in the material world. And when you were with Srila Prabhupada, you would hear things that you never heard before. Even you had studied Prabhupada's books and you had been with devotees. When you heard Prabhupada say things, there were so many things that would come out of Prabhupada like a waterfall of Krishna consciousness. And so many things that you never knew, you were being educated all the time, constantly. I saw Prabhupada again in Philadelphia at Rath Yatra. And we went to the airport to see Srila Prabhupada. And then we came to the temple, and Prabhupada gave a class on consciousness, different types. And then he said that there's a consciousness of the plant and a consciousness of the dog, and then he pointed to the devotees and said, and a consciousness like you. You know? So I heard only one class, and then I was on the Rath Yatra crew, and we had to watch the carts because the carts were parked behind the Philadelphia Art Museum. And the last 2 days of Prabhupada's presence in Philadelphia, I had to stay on the cart. But we didn't care because we were serving Prabhupada, and we knew the problem was, but we were just happy that we were saved. You know how the Krishna say they were saved? We knew we were saved. 24 hours, we knew we were under Prabhupada's umbrella. And Prabhupada gave the lecture at that Rath Yatra that I want to say now, because we just had Rath Yatra yesterday. Prabhupada gave the lecture, and he described how Lord Krishna took the form of Jagannath. And I've only heard this once, and I only heard it from Srila Prabhupada, and I've never heard it again, ever again. And Prabhupada was talking, and he said that Krishna was in Dwarka, and he was walking through his halls in the palace, and he came close to Rohini's room. And in the room, Rohini and Rukmini were speaking, and he stopped to listen to their conversation, to eavesdrop. And as he was eavesdropping on their conversation, Rukmini said to Rohini, who is Radha? When Krishna is asleep, he is saying, Radha, Radha. Who is Radha? And Rukmini said, Ravi and Krishna are very special, very, very special. Let me tell you the stories of Radha and Krishna. And as she started to describe the pastimes of Radha and Krishna, Krishna was eavesdropping. He heard it, and he became stunned. And his eyes got big, and his face got smiled, and his arms froze, and he took the form of Jagannath. So he was sitting in the hall frozen, like Jagannath. And then slowly, here comes down the hall Subhadra, and she sees that Krishna has taken the form of Jagannath, stunned, and he's sitting, and he's by the room of the with the door open. So she says, he must be listening. Why is he listening? So she starts to listen, and she also hears Radha Krishna Nichalila pastimes. And she hears, she becomes stunned, and she takes the form of Subhadra, let me see. And similarly, Balaram comes, and he listens, and he becomes stunned. And Prabhupada says, that's how we have the Jagannath, Krishna has taken this form. So I've never heard that before, but I heard that at Radha Yatra from Srila Prabhupada. I actually saw a video of that time, and I didn't hear Prabhupada talk about that. You know, it was like it wasn't filmed or something, but Prabhupada did say. So, how long do we have, and how long can we talk? Oh, let Maharaj speak.
Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Bita Das Ki Jai, Hare Krishna.